Does your Word document need a table of contents? I'll show you two ways to create one that updates itself and the pros and cons of each method coming up. Hi, I'm Deborah Saavedra of Legal Office Guru, your resource for legal professionals using Microsoft Office. And in today's video, I'm going to show you the two different methods for creating an automatic self-updating table of contents. Now, I will tell you up front, I have an unabashed preference for one particular method because I think it's easier to set up and offers a lot of benefits besides creating the elements for a TOC. However, the other method does have its advantages, and I want to be sure to show you both and let you decide what works best for you. Let's get started. Creating a table of contents necessitates somehow tagging certain bits of text to appear in the TOC. In other words, you have to tell Word what's significant enough to be listed in the TOC. Word has two different ways of marking TOC entries, both of which have pros and cons. Usually a TOC reflects the outline of your document, so those entries are usually the same as the headings and subheadings sprinkled throughout your document. So the simplest way is to use those same headings as your TOC entries by formatting them with a heading style. So if you go to the References tab, click on Table of Contents, then choose Custom Table of Contents, then click Options, you'll see the first set of choices for indicating what to include as a TOC entry, heading styles. Word has 9 heading styles, and from here you can choose how many of those heading styles you want to include in your table of contents and in what order. But further down you'll notice you've also got the option of using something called table entry fields. What are those? If you've ever created a table of authorities in Word, you'll recognize the process. Select the text you want to include and mark it as an entry for your table. While this is more cumbersome on the front end, notice that command doesn't even appear on the ribbon, unlike the mark entry commands for index and table of authorities. It does give you the ability to alter the listing in the table of contents to be different than the way it actually appears in the text. For example, perhaps one of your entries is a bit too long to include in your TOC. You could mark the entry in your text and shorten the TOC entry without altering the document text itself. Since the mark TOC entry doesn't appear in the ribbon, you'll have to do one of three things. A, memorize the shortcut key Alt-Shift-O, and that's the letter O, not 0. B, add the command to your quick access toolbar. Or C, add the command to a custom group or tab on the ribbon. To add the mark TOC entry command to either your quick access toolbar or to a new command group on the References tab on the ribbon, go to File, Options. The process is very similar in either case. You'll just start a bit differently. Let's add this to the quick access toolbar by first clicking on Quick Access Toolbar on the left. First, we'll need to find the mark entry command. Up here under Choose Commands From, I'm going to use this drop-down to list all commands. I could have just as easily used Commands Not in Ribbon for this one, but I want to show you how you can add any command to the interface. I'll scroll down and find Mark Entry, and then click on it. Over on the right is my Quick Access Toolbar. I can click the Add button to copy that command over to the Quick Access Toolbar, then use these up and down arrows on the far right to move it into whatever position makes sense for me. If you prefer to add this command to the ribbon, that's a very similar process. You'll start by clicking Customize Ribbon and continue to find the Mark Entry command as before. This time, however, you'll need to create a new command group on one of the tabs to hold it, since Word doesn't allow you to add commands to the existing groups. I'm going to create a new group on the References tab called TOC. To rename it, I'll click Rename. Now that I have a custom command group created on my References tab, I'll click Add to add the Mark Entry command to it. Once I've done that, I'm going to click OK to finish. Back in my document, I now have easy access to the Mark Entry command from either my Quick Access toolbar or my References tab over here on the right. Obviously, you don't have to put it in both places. You can pick whichever you prefer, or you can use the shortcut key Alt-Shift-O. That's the letter O, not a zero. Here, I'm going to select some text I want to mark as a TOC entry. Regardless of whether I use a button on the Quick Access toolbar or in my custom command group on the References tab, up pops this Mark Table of Contents Entry dialog box. The text I've selected automatically appears in the entry field. Here's where you can edit the actual TOC entry to be different from the actual text appearing in your document, if you wish. Leave the table identifier as C. In the Level field, you can tell Word what level in the hierarchy you want this to appear in. Level 1 entries will appear flush with the left margin, and subsequent levels, 2, 3, etc., will appear indented underneath as in an outline. Once you click Mark, you'll see a code in brackets appear next to the text you've selected. If you don't see it, click on the Show Hide button on the Home tab. It looks like a paragraph symbol. When it's a darker gray than the surrounding ribbon, it's toggled on. You can leave the Mark Table of Contents Entry dialog box up as you go through your document marking multiple entries. When you're done, click Close. Now it's time to actually insert your table of contents. Go to the References tab, click on Table of Contents on the far left, then choose Custom Table of Contents. Once you're in the Table of Contents dialog box, click Options to tell Word which method of marking your TOC entries you choose, styles or table entry fields. For this one, since I marked a couple of entries with the table entry fields, those bracketed codes you saw earlier, I'm going to uncheck both styles and outline levels and check the Table Entry Fields box. Once I click OK and OK again, Word inserts a table of contents based on the marking method I chose. So which method do you think you'll use in your documents? Have you used both methods before and prefer one over the other? Let me know in the comments below. And if you're in the middle of preparing a brief and you're having trouble keeping up with all the court's formatting requirements, maybe I can help. I've got a brief requirements checklist you can download free that'll help you sort through your court's various rules and get all your requirements in one place for easy reference. Just check the link above or in the description below to get your free checklist today.